when's the last time you've made a new friend?
You sound like someone that's fucking teaching junior infants.
A psychiatrist. Now, ladies and gentlemen, now, children, we've children, got a new girl.
Everybody.
Woman coming into the
Johnny,
class
look today. This way. When is the last time you made... And you have a little puppet.
Miss.
That you take out to go, here's my new friend. It's Pat the puppet. Hello, Pat.
Hello, Hector.
Okay, and let's start that again.
Can a dog be your new friend?
I'm just saying, we surround ourselves by people we know and people because of the environment and our daily routines. When is the last time you've embraced a new person and talked to and made a new friend that you made so quickly and easily in school and in university and on journeys? Because sometimes you slip back into... I don't make new friends. We should always make new friends.
How do we make new friends?
It's easily done.
Okay.
There's a mechanism in the human body for it. But I'm asking you now, as I open my hands to you,
right.
When is the last time or when recently...
Well, I have a question for you.
Yes.
How do you know, at what point do you go from knowing somebody and meeting them regularly for them to becoming your friend? So how, what...
Because they are a new person into your circle.
Yeah, when
have you started conversations with somebody you've never met before?
Yeah, I do that regularly. Conversations, but I don't bring them for lunch or coffee or bring them for drinks.
So when have you made a new friend? When is the last time you've added a new friend to your contact book?
But I'm putting new contacts into my phone regularly, but they're not... I don't know if...
Contacts aren't friends.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, but you just said, when did you make a new contact?
Yeah,
that's
but,
a friend.
Okay, contacts could be a contact for Johnny. He's a carpenter. He's
yeah.
not. Yeah. So what I'm saying to you, friends, you have friends.
But you need to have go through an experience with somebody for
yeah.
them, you know,
okay.
them to be your friend.
I'm only opening it up.
Yeah,
here.
But I'm interested about.
I know that.
Whoever takes us on the boat to Reykjavik, by the time we get there, we'll be a friend.
Well, will we?
He'll be a friend.
But you don't know, you see, until you meet somebody like that to say, he's my new friend or she's my
How
new
old
friend.
Are you?
Do you have to like not...
He's my new friend. Fucking...
I don't pour anything in here.
No, Tommy.
You're bringing another 8-year-old back to the house and you're telling your mom,
this is my friend,
this
Johnny.
Is Fintan. He's my new friend. He was friends.
Imagine it.
He was friends with Derek, but now he's my friend.
Yeah, he's in sixth class. What
We're
class
actually best friends now.
Tommy, have you made new friends recently?
No, but I meet a lot of people and I'd be having chats with them and stuff like that. But it takes a either you meet somebody and there's a connection, or else you go through some big experience together.
I'm thinking, let's think about that.
Yes, let's.
I know
and
loads
if everybody
of new
listening
people.
Could think about it as well, we'd all be thinking.
No, but like, surely is it not one of our challenges and one of the things we should be doing is by opening up and meeting new people and calling them.
Did your wife ever set up a play date for you? Did that ever happen to you?
No.
So say you're.
Please tell me it happened to you, Tommy.
Tommy,
you're going out at 11 to meet John.
Yeah. Say your wife has a really good friend. Right?
Oh, yeah.
And the two women are yapping together and they're such great friends and they go, I think our husbands would get on well together.
Oh.
And they're trying to set up a fucking play date for the fairy.
That sounds horrific.
It's bad.
I just said, you can tell him to fuck off.
Did you, what, was it even to the pub or what?
What? No, she said, we're going to go to dinner with...
Oh, yeah, that's okay, though.
And I went, what? I'll go to dinner, which I don't know those people.
You have to go do that.
No,
you don't.
That's a part of a couple. You go out for dinner with your couple, the other person in your relationships. That's how you make
friends. That's a warped idea of relationships, Laurita.
Are you telling me that if Yvonne's friend and her were going out for dinner, you and her husband wouldn't go, or partner or whatever it is?
Because we don't. Why would we go?
Because you talk to each other.
No,
you can't
spring surprises on married men like that if they don't really know the lad.
That's a surprise.
No, but you can't say, you can't. You
go and play with John there now.
Just because Yvonne and somebody else know each other and they're going for dinner, you cannot spring a surprise on Tommy or another married man because there's another
married man.
You can't.
Man. Well, so what if you two were friends, right?
We have been out on numerous occasions, the four of us, Dipnet and Yvonne and me and Tommy.
Yvonne would know each other.
And we have good crack together.
But anyway, let's just park that there.
We've got crack together because we know each other and there's no danger there. We're safe.
Yeah.
but and like, we sit together at the table.
Okay, let's just put it into perspective here. So
I would
you,
hate that.
You, Tommy, you and your imaginary friend.
What would you say to each other?
You and
where are you working? Do you play golf?
Yeah.
Are you, what are you drinking?
You get brought around to their house, and your woman says to you, John's in there and he's sitting there. You're going to talk to him.
Sit on the couch.
And you're in his house and you're going to sit down.
But that happens with women too. Oh,
fuck off.
That happens with women too.
How? When?
No, but you see.
When two men are friends,
yeah.
Then they go, oh, I'm going over to Mick's house and come on, we're going for dinner to Mick's house. And then,
that's never happened to me.
No.
So a man that you're friends with has never invited you and your wife for dinner.
No, Hector has never invited me to his house for dinner.
No, we always go
but
out
I'm just
for
saying
dinner.
More than Hector. We somebody
don't
do, else.
I don't ring Tommy
Hector.
And say, come on over to my house for dinner.
Why? Yeah.
Bring Yvonne, you can have a play date with Diplo.
No,
you're adults. Like, that's normal.
You might say
right?
A barbecue.
No. I think what you're trying to do, Laurita, is you're trying to impose a female habit or a female perception onto male minds.
No, you.
And we're refusing. We're going, no, keep your womanly stuff to your womanly people.
No, you said
let
you
the
were
men
the one
do
that, you
what
the
men want to do.
You were the one that brought it up.
Yes.
No, I brought up the friends thing. I brought it up.
Then he said, did you ever go on a play date with another man?
Yeah.
No, it would be terrible if it were, you had to go along because there's a husband there and there you're
in chat. He's in watching the race. Yeah.
Oh, Noel, how's it going? How are you, Noel? Have you had a punt? Have you back getting here, Noel? Yeah.
And
the women are out with the caravan. Yeah. Oh, yes, lovely.
I think they're getting on quite well.
I'm going to get a pink gin. Oh, I've got a pink gin. Have you any gunpowder? Oh, I love it. I love the gunpowder.
On the way back in the car, he says, that was all right. You decide, if you fucking ever bring me to that house again, I'm going to stab myself in the face.
But that happens
ever.
For women,
don't
too.
Don't ever have to sit there for 4 hours.
How is Noel?
I'm Noel.
Noel.
He's the most boring cunt ever.
Noel
took me out to see his golf clubs. He took me out to the fucking garage and he took each of the fucking...
He took out his ride on lawnmower. And don't ever fucking just leave me at home.
He was showing me photographs of other fucking ride on lawnmowers on his phone. I said, would you ever
and then meanwhile off? In the kitchen we have some hummus. Yeah, and I have a few dips here.
You don't do that?
No.
Never,
no,
you wouldn't do that.
No. Now, if there was a Junior C Division 3 match replay on and we could go and have a pint after, give us something and Noel would be in the element. Well, Noel, how's it going? How's things? Are we full sweat? No, we're not. You know, we need a vessel. We need
there and talk to Noel.
And then, look, what do you have? I'll have a bottle of Coors Light. What are you watching, Noel? Ah, a bit of At The Races.
Yeah. You have the ride on, is it? Oh, I do, yeah, and the job.
I got one.
I do the garden in 45 minutes. No way. Oh, yeah. You took me an hour and a half with the push more.
The idea of opening to new friends, I think we should all try and be friendly
to
somebody new.
I think we've established that you don't want to do that.
No, that's totally different. No, going on a dinner
that's
date.
That's forced friendship,
a play
is it?
Date. Wise words there. Wise words.